And from Kerala to Karnataka now, and with only months to go for the state assembly polls, former Deputy Chief Minister R. Ashok has upped the ante by charging the Congress government with tapping telephones of 162 senior political leaders across this political spectrum. He's now demanded a CBI or judicial probe. He's claimed that his information was authentic and has said that a retired police officer who was with the government was behind this, and that the Chief Minister, of course, has denied the allegations.
Nam BJP ennodu yaar virodha pakshalidare 162 phone galanna tap madidare bere enu madakagilla phone tapping martare tapping martare Congress bere dari avaru kaanta illa enana madi BJP avarge sondre kodbeku ee tara phone tap madadu BJP karyakartara kole galagavantadu
ನೋಡಪ್ಪ, ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋರು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರದವರು. ನಾವು ಯಾವತ್ತೂ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ, ಮಾಡೋದೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಮ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಕೇಂದ್ರದವರು. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ಏನಾದ್ರು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ ಚಿಲ್ಲರೆ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು.
ನೂರಕ್ಕೆ ನೂರು ಭಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜ್ಯ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಟೆಲಿಫೋನ್ ಕದ್ದಾಲಿಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರ. ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕಾಂಗ್ರೆಸ್ ಪಕ್ಷದ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ನಾಯಕರುಗಳನ್ನು ಭಾಳ ದಿನಗಳಿಂದಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಕದ್ದಾಲಿಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ನಾವು ಆ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಬರೀ ಟೆಲಿಫೋನ್ ಕದ್ದಾಲಿಕೆ ಒಂದೇ ಅಲ್ಲ.
With just months to go for the crucial 2018 assembly elections, former Home Minister and BJP leader R. Ashok has made a very serious allegation that the Chief Minister Siddaramaiah's government is involved in telephone tapping. On the other hand, Home Minister as well as Chief Minister has said that it's not the state government but the union government which is involving in phone tapping and misusing central agencies for political vendetta. Well, with just days to go for these elections, such kind of allegations will be flying thick and high. But is there any truth in this, or will Chief Minister indeed go for a judicial probe, remains to be seen. With video journalist Satish Jayaprakash for NewsX from Bengaluru.
He must come forward with whatever material he has and hand it over to the investigating agency, the local police. And the local police is expected to thereafter probe into that. And if they find any substance in that, they can register a crime and proceed. You see, otherwise they can make inquiry, or if cognizable offence is made out prima facie, in that case they would register an FIR and then carry on with the investigation.
I don't think there is any manner of doubt that Mr. Modi is making use of every surveillance measure to see to it that an authoritarian, totalitarian regime can be perpetuated by him.
This matter was clarified in the Ramakrishna Hegde versus Subramaniam Swami case, in which Ramakrishna Hegde lost and had to resign his chief ministership. So the law is very clear. No, center cannot tap telephones in Karnataka exchanges without the cooperation of the state government.